When it comes to using a character, there are various things you might want it to do. Perhaps you've got a human, a dog, a monster. There's various features which you might want the model and rig to have to make posing and animation easier. These things might include drivers for the fingers for easier posing. Corrective shape keys for the arms and legs so they'd bend without deforming. This plugin aims to give you features for the eyes of your model, with the intention being that you can easily copy these features and merge them from this preset here to any model you have, regardless of how many eyes or where they are. This tutorial will show you this merging process. So what does the eye rig have? For one thing, it has these three bones here which controls the eyes. This is a view target. The eyes are designed to point towards it. The smaller circles control one eye at a time. But you can observe that this doesn't just move the eyes, but the eyelids around it to simulate more expression and realism. Since now you know exactly what this is and what it does, let's go and see how we can merge this to your potential model. Selecting everything here, we're going to copy the assets and go over to the other project. There we'll make a folder called Eye and paste the assets inside. These two shapes here are the meshes used for the custom bones over here. They can be deleted without issue. This is the 3D mesh we're going to work on. It's a fairly standard mesh, just some bones that control how it moves around. Bone for the head, two eyes, but they don't have any controls yet. It does, however, have the shape keys necessary for the eyelids. An up and down shape key for both the upper and lower eyelids, or for the left and right eye. 8 shape keys in total. If your model doesn't have shape keys, that's not a problem. You can easily create your own using the shape keys in this mesh as a reference, as a placeholder from which you can copy. As I've mentioned, it doesn't matter how many eyes the face has, where they are, or how the mesh looks, this process will still work. But before we do anything else, we have to make sure the shape keys will transfer correctly. This means we have to rename the shape keys on the eye-rigged model to have the same names of the shape key equivalents on the base model. In other words, the 8 shape keys over here need to have the same names as the same shape keys over here. If you're making your own shape keys, then just create them with the same names as in the eye model. You can make sure you're renaming them correctly by going through each of them one at a time. Activate this button to show only the selected shape key. Find or make the equivalent in the other mesh. Copy the name from one and paste it into the other. Now we have to make sure that all the bones are in their default pose. Otherwise, when we come to join the armatures together, we'll get some unpredictable behavior. After you do that, you'd have to decide if you'd like to keep the new eyes or to use the original ones in your model. For this, we'll just use the new ones so the swapping process can be shown. Having that in mind, we can just go ahead and join this model with this model, without the worry that they wouldn't align. If you want to use the new eyes, all you'd have to do is delete the eyes that came with the model, and then carefully align the new eyes into the sockets. You'll want to put the root of the eye rig to the same location as the root of the model's armature. To do this, with the armature selected, use Shift S, cursor to select it, and then select the armature of the eye, Shift S again and object to cursor. Now you can move the eyes up into the head by going into pose mode and moving this root bone at the back. Doing it by this way will ensure there is no complications when you come to join them together. Next, we're going to click the head and then shift click the eye mesh. And now, right clicking, we will use join. If we had clicked the eye mesh and then the head, it wouldn't have kept the drivers we had set up for the mesh around the eyes. If your head already has drivers, this process will remove them. So in that eventuality, rather than joining them, assuming you want to use your own eyeballs, just go through the 8 shape keys for the eyelids, right click on them, and paste them into the value of the equivalent shape keys on the head. Doing this is also going to change what the parent of the model is. In the case of the head, select it, and then shift select the rig, and set the parent to the object, pressing Ctrl P to open up the parent menu, and clicking to keep the transform. Since aligning the bones to the eyes is as easy as just moving the small end bones to the center of the eyeballs in edit mode, I'll quickly just show you how to align the bones in the head if you're using the default eyes. Specifically, which bones to adjust and which to leave so things keep working. We're going to do this the same way you would normally do with a mesh, just by moving it. If you want to move their location, then it's this bone. If you want to change their rotation, use this bone. For change in scale, edit these bones at the end here. So let's see. This one maybe needs to be scaled down slightly. Now move them forwards. Just make sure that these bones don't have any animation, and make sure not to animate them, or their positions risk being reset, and you'll have to put them back in their place. If you need to animate the eyes, just use the viewtarget. Now that everything is properly set up and the eyes are aligned, we can just select the eye bone rig, and then select the rest of the rig, right click, and join. The bones may disappear from sight, but we can reappear them by shift clicking these layers. It depends on what your default rig has in these layers. All that's left to do is to make sure the vertex groups are working, and then we can double check the drivers. For the shape keys in the eye rig, you need to check the names of the two eye bones at the end of the rig. In this case, one is called L eyeball, the other R eyeball. If you merged the head to the eye model correctly, you should see under the list of vertex groups two vertex groups with those same names. If the name here matches the name of a bone, it means that anything active within this group is being moved by that bone. So, clicking on the model, we'll go into vertex paint mode so we can see what's what. Blue means not affected, red means fully affected, and make sure that the left eyeball is being used in the left vertex group and vice versa for the right one. If it's not, you can go into edit mode, select the whole eye, go over to vertex groups, put the slider here to max, and click assign. Now if we check back, we see that the eye is red, and the bone is now controlling it. Check this on both, and you'll now find that the eyes are able to track the view target. As to the drivers, the reason you're not seeing any movement from them yet is because the vertex groups of the shape keys of the face haven't yet been switched over. They're still using the vertex groups of the eye model that this came with, and not the vertex groups for the left and right side of the face. If you already have vertex groups for the left and right side of the face, you can just use those in the normal way you would. But if you don't know how to do that, or if you don't have one, I'll just show you how you can create them. First, we'll click the head model and open it in vertex paint mode. We'll go to front view here like this, select the gradient tool, and create two new vertex groups. We'll call one left face, the other right face perhaps. Now, with one of them selected, with the gradient tool, select the left half of the face for the left vertex group and the opposite side for the right vertex group, making sure that it's perfectly or near enough half and half split down the middle of the face. Go through each of the shape keys and make sure to change the name of the vertex group being used to match up with the left and right side vertex groups you either are using before or just created. As you can now see, the eyes not only track the mesh around, but the mesh around the eyes also reacts to these movements. And there you have it. The eye tracks the view target, the eyelids also move up in sync. Using this system, you can easily add drivers and shape keys to your 3D model. Add extra eyes, remove them, change the eyes of the new model to work with your own, and do whatever else you need this to do. This saves you the time and hassle of having to figure and create this process yourself, giving you a stable tool to modify or create additions to models that are otherwise lacking. Thank you for watching. That's all for this time.